This is a presentation on Parkinson's disease. The learning objectives of this presentation are to enable the student to recognize the cardinal and associated features of Parkinson's disease. At the end of this presentation, you should also be able to describe the pathophysiology and treatment options for Parkinson's disease. You should also be able to describe the differential diagnosis of Parkinson's disease and secondary causes of Parkinsonism. An introduction of Parkinson's disease will open the lecture, followed by the cardinal features and gait of Parkinson's disease. The lecture will then describe the pathophysiology of Parkinson's disease. Treatment in the form of pharmacological and non-pharmacological approaches will also be outlined. Parkinson's disease was also known as paralysis agitans and was first described by James Parkinson in his 1817 classic monograph, An Essay on the Shaking Palsy. Parkinson's disease is a progressive degenerative disease with a mean age of diagnosis of 70 years. It is uncommon in people younger than 40, and incidence increases rapidly over the age of 60. The cardinal features of Parkinsonism are a tremor of 4 to 5 Hz rest tremor, bradykinesia, and rigidity. Postural instability is often considered a cardinal feature of Parkinsonism. However, it usually presents much later in the disease. Other additional features include gait disturbance, postural instability, and autonomic dysfunction causing postural hypotension, gastroparesis, constipation, erectile dysfunction, and urinary urgency, and incomplete bladder emptying. The Parkinsonism gait is easily recognizable because of the stooped posture, short shuffling steps, reduced arm swing, tendency for freezing and turning on block. The symptoms and signs of Parkinsonism can be caused by a variety of causes. Idiopathic Parkinsonism is referred to as Parkinson's disease. Secondary causes of Parkinsonism include drugs like antipsychotics and dopamine antagonists. Toxins such as MPTP and organic solvents are also known to cause secondary Parkinsonism. Other causes include head trauma, metabolic causes like Wilson's disease and neuroacanthocytosis, certain infections like progressive multifocal leukoencephalopathy and encephalitis lethargica, and normal pressure hydrocephalus. Vascular Parkinsonism refers to Parkinsonism which is related to multiple cerebral vascular events. Parkinson's plus syndromes include progressive supranuclear gaze palsy, multisystem atrophy, Lewy body dementia, and corticobasal degeneration. In the early stages of Parkinson's disease, patients often present with unilateral symptoms and/or rest tremor. There is often preservation of postural reflexes and significant and sustained response to dopaminergic therapy. As Parkinson's disease progresses, there is slow worsening with symptoms becoming bilateral and the response to dopaminergic therapy becomes variable. In the later stages, patients often experience postural instability. In Parkinson's disease, there is loss of melanin-containing dopaminergic neurons in the substantia nigra, locus ceruleus, and dorsal motor nucleus of the vagus nerve. There are also eosinophilic intracellular cytoplasmic inclusions known as Lewy bodies in the brainstem and other parts of the brain. The end result is dopamine deficiency in the negrostriatal pathway and relative hyperactivity of the striatal cholinergic activity. First-line treatment for Parkinson's disease include L-DOPA replacement with levodopa-carbidopa combination, dopamine agonist, and monoamine oxidase. Levodopa-carbidopa combination and dopamine agonist are both effective for rigidity and bradykinesia and can be used in combination. Dopamine agonist, however, is recommended as first-line therapy in patients below 65 years old. This is because it is associated with fewer motor fluctuations, less side effects of dyskinesias, and can delay onset of levodopa therapy. Monoamine oxidase inhibitor is used as add-on therapy in early Parkinson's disease, and it has neuroprotective effects. It in itself is modestly effective in symptomatic treatment. Catechol-O-methyltransferase inhibitors like entacapone is used in combination with levodopa to potentiate its effects and is useful for end of dose wearing off. Anticholinergics like benzaxol are used predominantly to treat tremors. Amitriptyline, however, is useful for motor fluctuations and reducing dyskinesia in advanced PD. More recently, deep brain stimulation has been successfully implemented for the treatment of Parkinson's disease. Other surgical options such as thalamotomy, pallidotomy, and subthalamotomy are now rarely performed since the advent of deep brain stimulation. Holistic management of the patient with involvement of allied health leads to better outcomes. It is crucial for Parkinson's disease patients to maintain physical activity and good nutrition. Later on in the disease, they develop bulbar bradykinesia, leading to dysphagia, for which they will need consultation with a speech therapist. In summary, Parkinsonism consists of a triad of tremor, bradykinesia, and rigidity. Idiopathic Parkinsonism is referred to as Parkinson's disease. It is caused by degeneration of neurons in the substantia nigra, resulting in dopamine deficiency. Treatment is mainly targeted at replacing or potentiating dopamine. The age of the patient influences drug selection. In some cases, surgical options with deep brain stimulation should be explored. Maintenance of physical activity is crucial. It is important to recognize other causes of Parkinsonism to guide treatment. Thank you for listening to this VAP.